Hi everyone, welcome back to BankExamstoday.com, and this is our day 6 of 5 minutes daily vocabulary. Today we are going to learn 5 new words picked from the Hindu newspaper. So 5 new words are going to start with the word ubiquitous. Ubiquitous, recently in the SEBI grade A exam there was a paragraph and reading comprehension paragraph, and from that paragraph this word was picked and the students were asked to find out its antonym. So ubiquitous is something or someone that is present everywhere. Okay, so you can name it as omnipresent. Omni means everywhere and present means that is present everywhere. So ubiquitous is present, appearing or found everywhere. For example, you can say air is ubiquitous. Then we have internet connection that is very much prevalent to all over the globe or world. So ubiquitous is something that is found everywhere wherever you go, and it is very hard to escape it. The synonyms are omnipresent, as I told you, ever present, pervasive, universal and worldwide. Antonyms are rare, because if something is found everywhere, the opposite of it will be rare, hard to find. Scarce, again very hard to locate or find, negligible and sparse. Example is, he aims to make his product ubiquitous by selling it internationally, because he wants his products to be recognized worldwide. Therefore he is selling it internationally. Second word is amplify. Amplify is a very easy word to memorize when you are using amplifier. Amplifier is used to expand the sound, right? So amplify means to enlarge or add details to something. It is keep on increasing and increasing and increasing, so that increasing is called amplifying. Okay, so it is increasing, it is boosting, magnifying or escalating, anything you want to name it. Antonyms are decreasing, compressing, because when you are expanding the sound, and the opposite will be compressing it. Condense, weaken, diminish or reduce. The examples are, I refuse to watch TV anymore because how news stations amplify bad news. Amplify, they magnify it. If there is a bad news, they are going to repeat it again and again and again. That is quite irritating and it makes you anxious. That if something bad is happening like this, this could happen to me as well. So they amplify the bad news, that makes people anxious. Next word is insinuate. Insinuate is another word, you can say it is suggest, but suggesting something negative. For example, if you are a teacher and someone brings the homework notebook to you, you remember the writing of that student, and somehow you notice that in the notebook the writing is not matching to the student's handwriting. So you say, did you write this yourself? So what are you hinting, what are you suggesting that is going to offend that person? Because if he hasn't written it himself, then it is surely going to offend him. So insinuating is to suggest something negative, which is actually true. You see this picture, you are insinuating, I ate your goldfish, okay, I am offended. Obviously no other person in the house will eat the goldfish, so this is the cat who ate it. This is a bad thing. And when I am asking, when I am hinting who ate the goldfish, I am insinuating something negative. So when you suggest or hint something negative, that is insinuate. The synonyms are imply, suggest, hint, whisper or indicate, and the antonyms are conceal, you hide it, leave alone or withhold, you just keep it to yourself, not to ask anyone, just let it be. Example, are you trying to insinuate I did not complete my homework on my own? It means I am hinting that you did not complete your homework. That is something bad, but it's true. The next word is proliferate. Proliferate, proliferate. Okay, so the next word is proliferate. Again, the another word for amplifying. Okay, increase in number very quickly, very rapidly. So synonyms are multiply, like something is going to be increasing and increasing and increasing. Mushrooming, burgeon, escalate, same as amplify. The words are different, but the meaning is exactly the same. And the antonyms can be same again: decrease, lessen, shrink, decline, or fall off. Example: as problems with the business continue to proliferate, Edward decided to retire. It means when the problems in the business continued to increase or multiply, Edward decided to quit or retire. Then the last word for today is inadvertent. Inadvertent, when you do not do something deliberately. For example, you are driving your car and accidentally, not intentionally, your car hits the car ahead of you like this. This girl did not do it intentionally because she was driving. Maybe she was lost in thoughts or something like this, and there is a collision of the cars, which is not intentional. So inadvertent, not resulting or achieved through deliberate planning. It means you do not plan it, but it just happens. Okay, so like spilling of coffee, spilling of milk somewhere, you losing your keychain, or you lose your keys. These are all are the things that we do not plan to do, but sometimes these happen. So it is inadvertent, something unintentional, unintended, accidental, unpremeditated, or unplanned. Opposite to it, careful, cautious. It means you planned it. You planned it very carefully, intentionally. Advertent, attentive, deliberate, and planned. The example is, after working on it for 5 hours, I thank goodness I caught myself before I made an inadvertent deletion of the whole report. It means he was going to delete the whole report on which he worked for 5 hours. And that deletion would be inadvertent. He did not plan to delete the report, but he could delete it. Right? So inadvertent, that you do not plan to do, but it happens sometimes. So this is all about today's 5 words. I hope you like the video, and if you like it, just subscribe to our channel, like the video, share it with your friends, or you can download the PDF in the description board. And if you have any queries regarding our courses, just call on this number 906-720-1000. We will be glad to help you.